Let's take a look at some of the changes to Sketch text in the October 2020 update. When you begin the text command in the Sketch environment, you will be prompted to select between regular text and text on path. Regular text is on by default. We will talk about text on path later. The cursor is now across, and you are prompted to create a bounding box or a text frame for the text. Type in the text. You have pretty much the standard options here. What is new this time is that you are able to position the text within the bounding box using these alignment options. Most of the time, when I am dealing with text features, I will try to position it with respect to the center of the text. So it would make sense to center align the text both horizontally and vertically within the bounding box. This will allow you to position the text using the centroid of the bounding box. If you hover the cursor over the bounding box, it will trigger green points at the corners, the midpoints, and the centroid. You can click on these and pivot the text about these points. If you do not need the text to be angled, you can confirm the text feature and add a horizontal constraint on the edge of the bounding box. After some testing, I have found that I am not able to dimension to the centroid. The dimension tool just does not seem to be able to pick up the centroid. I was also not able to add constraints to the centroid. Let me know in the comments if you face this problem as well. A workaround is to manually draw a diagonal line and set it to construction. The midpoint of this diagonal will coincide with the centroid of the bounding box. If I want to dimension between the origin and this point, start the dimension tool, click on the origin, and then hold down shift and hover over the diagonal until you see a triangle which indicates that you are above the midpoint of the diagonal. Click again at this point. You might also want to dimension the length and width of the bounding box to fully define the sketch. Usually, we would want to dimension the height of the box to be the same height as the font. Let's create a new text and try out the text on path feature. Once you select that option, you will be prompted to select a path. This can be an open spline or a closed path such as a circle. You can also use the edge of an existing solid. The placement and flip options are pretty self-explanatory. Don't forget that the path can also be a straight line. So here is a center point rectangle. I can pick the bottom edge as a path, adjust the placement and flip options, and center align the text. If I choose the fit to path option, this will adjust the spacing between characters to match to the length of the path. Let's keep the font at 10. Confirm the text. We can dimension the rectangle to match the font height. So with that, we have actually created a much more useful bounding box compared to the one that came with the regular text option. Being a center rectangle, it naturally has a centroid from which you can dimension to. Adjusting the width automatically adjusts the spacing of the letters. Unfortunately, the same cannot be done for the font size. I have attempted to set a parameter and use that parameter to define both the height of the bounding box and the font size. When I change the parameter, the height of the box updates, but not the font size. But still, this is a much more useful bounding box compared to the one that you get in the regular text option. You can double-click on one of the edges of the bounding box to select the whole chain and set them to construction. For text on path, take note that the paths have to be on a plane. So no 3D curves here. You can, however, emboss this on a curved surface to get more complex-looking text patterns.